What's up, everyone? Welcome back to the channel. Hope that you're doing well. Thank you, as always, for showing up, stopping by, not being late, not being absent. Today, we're going to listen to The Gem. We're going to listen to the track English Rose off of the album All Mod Cons, which we've been going through little by little, released 1978. The title of the track English Rose sounds familiar, and I can't exactly tell you why. I'm pretty sure I haven't heard this track before. I don't think it's that reason, but for some reason the title track English Rose sounds familiar. Even though just looking it up, I'm just seeing an actual rose. So I'm sure it's not, but for some reason it did sound familiar. So I just wanted to check on that, see if it was a cover or something like David Wells. Anyways, let's listen to the track. We'll talk about it after. Let's have a good time. Let's go. Housekeepers. After a fun little jam of Mr. Watts, English Rose is incredibly beautiful, just very relaxing, very serene. I love the guitar playing alongside the ocean waves, just setting you in that particular place, putting you in that particular mood. That feels good. And of course, Weller's very soft singing, his very soft voice, just carrying us along with everything. I think that this was just a very sweet and sentimental piece. It felt good. And that's what matters. Now, I am curious. The next track is In the Crowd. We're going to listen to that one, too. Let's get into the lyrics here, which I think it's pretty simple. No matter where I roam, I will return to my English rose, for no bonds can ever tempt me from she. I've sailed the seven seas, flown the whole blue sky, but I've returned with haste to where my love does lie. No matter how far he goes, no matter where he's been, he always returns to his love, his English rose. I've been to ancient worlds, I've scoured the whole universe, and caught the first train home to be at her side. No matter where I roam, I'll return to my English rose, for no bonds, nothing and no one can ever keep me from she. It's a very straightforward track. It's a very straightforward meaning and message behind the lyrics, but it sounds good, it feels good, it means well. sometimes beauty is in simplicity, and I like that a lot. That felt really, really good. But I am curious as to how that soft, beautiful melodic track transitions into the next one, In the Crowd, which also ends side one of the album. So let me back up just a moment here to the last few seconds of English Rose, and we're gonna let that ring around the rosy. Let's go. It's gonna be a slap in the face, isn't it?
Sunshine when I'm in the crowd, I don't see anything. I fall into a trance at the supermarket. The night blows me along as I catch falling cans. Our babies on toast. Technology is the most, and everyone sees just like me. They struggle hard to set themselves free.
No doubt each of these tracks has really stellar guitar work, but how did you guys feel about that ending solo, about Weller's guitar work there? Because I thought that was really interesting. Once again, if you're new here, I don't know anything about guitar, so I'm just speaking, right? But it sounds really cool what he's doing there, because first of all, effect-wise, it sounds like he's like fading in a lot of the notes like really quick, like he plays a note and fades it in on the volume really quick. And then he gives a lot of vibrato in certain places. It almost has a theremin-like movement in the strings itself. And then he'll drop down the volume really quick, so the note just cuts off completely. Then he'll kind of fade it in really quick. Like, there's a lot of gymnastics going on on the actual knobs on the guitar. At least I think so. That's what it sounds like. And then, like I said, the movement itself has a little bit of a theremin-like vibrato to it. It sounds a little bit Frippian to me. Like, just a little bit. I would not be surprised if maybe there is some correlation, some influence or something, maybe. I don't know. Either way, it's fantastically done. Weller's guitar sings alongside with him as well, especially in the chorus. Like after he says, like in the crowd, like his guitar, he plays the notes, the melodies over it again. Foxton. Foxton is just playing beautifully. just absolutely gorgeous. You could say, like, the bass is, of course, carrying the rhythm and the melody, backing up the guitar and the lead and everything like that. But Foxton is, he's really just putting it down on this one. He's hitting really good. And then Buckler's having a grand old time, just swinging back and forth in here. It's very catchy. It's very upbeat. It's not as heavy as I thought it would be, like a slap in the face coming off of the last track. I thought it would be, like, an immediately backhand. But it's not. It's actually a nice, upbeat jam that you would expect from the jam. Listening to them here. It's not the exact moment I was looking for, but it was close. It was before that I was looking for, when the guitar, when Weller basically duets with himself, just one vocal, one guitar. And they have a great way of being heavy in certain moments in their own way, and then lightening that up, like how it's getting heavy there, but lightens up in the chorus. Hear Foxton? Ba-da-dum, da-dum, bum, ba-da-dum. Then he goes, like, just, it's just really great movement from all the instruments and everyone involved here. The lyrics, when I'm in the crowd, sorry, my computer's making noise. When I'm in the crowd, I don't see anything. My mind goes a blank in a humid sunshine. When I'm in the crowd, I don't see anything. I fall into a trance at the supermarket. The noise flows me along as I catch falling cans of baked beans on toast. Technology is the most. And everyone seems just like me. They struggle hard to set themselves free, and they're waiting for a change. Kind of like you can't see the forest from the trees. He's in the crowd, so perhaps he's not seeing other things outside of the crowd. And that particular moment, he's just being part of the crowd. He is part of the crowd. The crowd is him. He is the crowd, etc., etc. When I'm in the crowd, I can't remember my name, and my only link is a pint of Wall's ice cream. When I'm in the crowd, I don't see anything. Sometimes I think that it's a plot, an equilibrium melting pot. The government sponsors underhand when I'm in the crowd. Like, as long as he's in the crowd and everyone's kind of moving along, like, you know, a crowd generally moves the same way or acts the same way. A crowd generally has some sort of psychological conformity in the way that they move and act. So as long as he's in the crowd, he can't perhaps think or feel independent. You know what I mean? Like, if you think about someone being physically in a crowd, you're part of the crowd. You can't, you know, you're not outside the crowd. If you were outside the crowd, you wouldn't be in the crowd. And don't forget, you saw it here first when I'm in the crowd. And life just simply moves along in simple houses, simple jobs. And no one's wanting for the change when I'm in the crowd, when I'm in the crowd. So everyone has their little pattern in life, as we all do. And in a sense, because of that pattern, we're all in the crowd. And it takes a lot to get out of the crowd. Something like that. I think there's something like that going on in the lyrics. Let me know what you guys thought of the two tracks. You can let me know in the comments down below. You can follow me on Twitter. You can support the channel on Patreon. Hope you enjoyed the music. Hope you enjoyed your time here. Come on back tomorrow. Why did I say it like that? And I'll see you later. Bye.